I first introduced you to one another, you will remember that there was a bit of a plot afoot. Did you mind being, or did you know that it was a...
Thunderclap Newman's album is called Hollywood Dream.
Me being such a famous pop star and all, I tended to tell a lot of people that I could help them and never get around to actually doing it.
Thunderclap Newman was produced by Pete Townshend.
It was electric the way they came together, you know, Andy's old time 1920s piano, but with a difference somehow, with a sinister difference, and Speedy's incredibly straight, functional kind of drumming, and Jimmy's amazing young guitar.
Thunderclap Newman is Andy Newman, Speedy Keen, Jimmy McCulloch, a three-man group.
Speedy and Jimmy immediately loved the idea of working with Andy Newman. But Andy Newman didn't want to join at first because he worked for the GPO, which is our post office system, and he didn't want to lose his pension. He eventually left his job and joined, and we started making recordings. The amazing thing about the way they work in the studio is that they've all definitely got different, completely different states of mind. But the I don't know, it's a kind of a catalytic thing that the way you have to explain it. I mean, the fact that they each give away to the one another as a concession to playing with the other practically 90% of their own musical personality. I see Mary standing by the riverside waiting. She thinks the Queen is coming by. Then I looked around and she was gone. Why? I sit in the box like freaking out. I've never been so satisfied with the way something came together. I see Jimmy climbing on the milkman's van, laughing on his feet were pilgrim their shoes. Then I looked around and he was gone. Are we to lose? Speedy walked into my flat in Chelsea and sat on the sofa looking quite scary, actually. I'd heard that he'd been in prison for a couple of years, and he sat there and in a very, very broad, thick Cockney accent, immediately came across as being someone who was an incredible observer.
It, like, to reach your peak is when you can act like a total mirror,
right,
you know, to all the people that maybe can't play the guitar, or
right,
you know what I mean, or can't, you know, do anything creative, you know, right, except maybe freak out on a Saturday night in a dance. Look around, see what it's all.
Jimmy, I met, well, I think he was about 12 years old, and his guitar was like twice as big as he was. And I said, "You're in a group, wow," you know. And they followed us on. And I went out and watched them, and I couldn't believe how good he was. Like, astoundingly good, you know, for his age. And after that, it was all forgotten. I never saw him again until one day I met him in Denmark Street, England's Tin Pan Alley, looking for help.
When I first took up the guitar, you know, my father, he was a musician, and my grandfather, my great-grandfather, so,
a bit like me.
I had a sort of, like, gift when I started out, you know? And, I like music, I like to listen to music, and I like playing it, you know? It doesn't really matter what it is.
Speak, man. Give it to them.
The first time I met Andy Newman, I was at art school, and everywhere I went in the college one day, there were posters saying, "Thunderclap Newman plays today," you see. So we all thought, Thunderclap Newman must be an obsolete jazz star. So we all collect in the lecture theatre, waiting. And out of the corner of my eye, I see this rather peculiar guy with, I think it's best that the first thing image I got was his shape, which was a bit like a turnip. This can't be Thunderclap Newman. And he gets on the piano and starts to play. And as his fingers start to tinkle, you know, I mean, the magic mood that just sifted through. After the lecture theatre appearance, he disappeared, and then friends and I used to get hold of tapes of his and listen to them and just completely, like worship him from afar. I remember the second time I met him was when we saw him in the street, my mate and me, saw him in the street walking along, looking in the gutter at things and stopping and taking off his glasses and looking at something here and something there and stroking his beard and then walking on a bit. And we were following him going, blimey, it's him, it's Thunderclap Newman. Look out like a couple of teeny boppers, you know. And just as we were about to scream up and ask for his autograph, you know, he got on a bus and disappeared.
A little claustrophobic, but apart from that, most amicable and very, very, very fine company, I might add. Music is a form of expression which transcends language and words. I feel that it has a greatness which surpasses mere material things, and if I die having done something musically great, I will die happy. But if I don't do anything really good musically, I've no intention of doing anything good musically, 5 minutes from this second I shall put a bullet through my head.
Speedy is a very, very, very close friend of mine, actually. I haven't seen him for a long time, but there was a period when he used to be with me all the time. He used to, for all intents and purposes, work for me as a driver, but I mean our relationship extended beyond that. We used to work together a lot on music. I used to help with his demo recordings and he used to play drums on mine. Jimmy is much, much tougher than he looks. He's one of those guys that can be a little bit hard right at the right moment. And I think this is probably why some bits of his guitar work are so solid, you know, and other bits are so sympathetic. Andy is just a complete farce. He's a walking farce. A total farce. Just the sight of him makes me laugh sometimes. Although I'm getting used to him now. But I mean, at one time it was a point where sometimes... His music, though, I never laugh at that. I mean, if I do laugh, it's laughter of someone who's, like, hysterically happy, you know. Because his music is just completely... I feel it's, like, partly mine, you know. And I think a lot of people get that feeling.
Where I come from. If you wasn't a musician, you was a lorry driver, you know, one of the two.
There's nothing really definite I dislike about Andy or anything.
Well, I've been buttonholed in worse ways in my life, notably by the telephone manager.
I wish there was a Hollywood just like there used to be.
Thank you. Very kind.